Yes, we've been Olympia champions, Nicole Wilkins.
Four-time Olympia champion.
Well, Nicole, four-time Olympia champ, the winningest figure Olympia champion in history, of course. You made your epic battles over the years, but I remember those going back and forth with Aaron Stern and losing a title and getting it back and all that. And now you got a new one that came up. And the competition, once again, was done with all the usual names, Candace Keene, Candace Lewis, Kamala. So you found yourself right in the battle there. How did you feel going into the competition?
All of the girls that were competing on the stage, especially the top six, I think this year was one of the best top six that I've seen on the figure stage. You guys know I've been here before. I got second place twice, came back twice, so honestly, I'm more motivated than ever. And they might have got it right yesterday, but they won't get it right next year. I love you.
We've got some good stuff going on there. How about a rematch right here, right now on this stage?
I mean, yesterday I was definitely off my best. I wasn't so far off, obviously, that I didn't deserve a second, in my opinion. But Latoya looked awesome. She has a great shape. She deserved to win yesterday, and I congratulate you. You did an amazing job.
Thank you. Thank you.
You know, outside of a true champion aspect, nothing less for me, Nicole, always. I gotta be honest, I thought you looked fantastic. I did both of you. Like I said, the top six was loaded. Truly the best of the best on there. But you know what? That's what makes the Olympia special, is that you can have two top Olympians on stage going against each other. And it was so clear to judges have to make a decision. But like I said, this is not unfamiliar ground to you. You lost the title, you gained it back.
And I will do it again. I'm not done yet. I know what I need to do. I've done it before, and I am starting today for my drive for five. It's still alive for next year, baby.
I'm so glad you enjoyed it. Thank you, Nicole. Well, without further ado, I'm going to give it obviously everybody on the panel, but we got to get from a man down there. I don't want to fall asleep. Ladies and gentlemen, the great Dexter Jackson. The champ just keeps coming back and coming back. That's 45, you're going to be 46 in November, I understand?
Yes.
I don't think people really can get a feel for that. Obviously, these guys can, but to do what he does at almost 46 years of age is literally unheard of. To be second in the world at anything that you do in your 40s, let alone at 46, absolutely amazing, guys. My hat's off to you, Trevor. That's, we all heard the hype coming to the show, Kai Greene, which of course we will address not the competition this year, choosing not to compete. But as you said at the press conference, did it bother you one bit?
No, because I had a game plan coming into the show. I was expecting to beat Kai anyway, so. And I know you can call me.
George is taping this right now, believe me. He's not ready to see it. Oh, okay. But you know what? We didn't want to focus on who wasn't here. We had to focus on who is here.
Exactly.
Man, to your right, Sean Roden, pushing you the entire way. Phil, obviously, the rest of the Olympians. This was truly a great Olympia, folks. Next, after the prejudging, we got a chance to talk outside, and we just kind of go over the prejudging, you know, what do you think and all that. And I thought that you were actually clearly in second at that point. That seemed to surprise you, though.
When at the win?
At the prejudging.
I thought me and Sean and Phil were really, really close. I didn't know which way it would go, but I thought it was a toss-up between the three of us.
Absolutely. I mean, it was for you, actually.
There was not a lot
of three.
I love Dennis, but Dennis wasn't as good as he used to be.
And he's not here, so we can talk about him.
So I tell him the same thing on me.
I keep it real.
Yeah.
Yeah, you do. Well, you're keeping it on stage, man, and like I said, head judge Steve Weinberger was mixing and matching. He was working you guys. Listen, there wasn't one athlete on this Olympia stage this year that could complain that they didn't get a fair shot or a fair look. He must have put you guys 30 turns on stage.
I mean, this is Olympia, man. This is what you can ask kind of for. He's supposed to work. We should be very, very, you know, we should be in shape, ready to perform for you guys. And I'm glad he worked us a bit like that. I'm glad everybody got prepared. And I'm glad they put him next to Phil and Sean, or, you know, because usually if they don't do that, then it's hard to see who should be winning. You know what I'm saying? So that played a big part in the place to say.
Well, second place is bringing it up. Obviously, I know you're very pleased with that. Let me get your opinion on some of the other champs. Big Ronnie.
Big Ronnie was big.
He is big. You know, and obviously we joke around maybe, but when you stand next to this guy, he's huge. I mean, he's huge. I saw him step on the scale. Like the weight I put out the last night wasn't just for height purposes. I was actually standing there as he stepped on the scale at the competitors meeting. And he stepped on the scale at 316 pounds. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, that's pretty funny for me. Yes. I think one of his legs is like bigger than both of mine.
Well, bigger doesn't necessarily go best, as we know that
is. This is bodybuilding. This is, you know, it's more than just sheer size. I've proven it over the years. I won Olympia at 230, now 245, so it was great to be able to come back and fight for the title again, especially at my age.
240, but you started at 145.
Yeah, I started at 145 my first year.
But at 100 pounds.
Yeah.
Big Tex.
I'm Big Tex, now I'm 245.
Well, Tex ain't slowing down now. You got some shows coming up.
Yes. Sean and I are going to battle it out again next week in Spain and also in Cumberland Park too, and in Prague. So, you know, we train in the same gym, you know, we buddy, you know, when we're not getting ready for a show, and it's like 2 weeks out, we're like, shh, I ain't trying to look at
him. That's cracking himself up, man. Well, that's got to be interesting. I mean, two top Olympians in the same gym, you don't see a whole lot of them.
Yeah, you know, I'm taking it back to the old school because I know it used to be back in the day with all those guys. And, you know, we got Sean, we had a lot of pros in that gym. It's awesome. That's why I go out and train in that gym. If I was still in Florida training by myself, I'd probably retire now because I was like, no motivation at all. So, you know, at first everybody was like, what are you going on there in LA training? Are you crazy? My girlfriend's over here, and I'm like, you so stupid, they can go all the way out there, staying months at a time. But now that I'm winning, you're the smartest guy out
there.
And get back, you know, and get with George, man. It's been a blessing to train with Charles Glass, and to have George Fair in my corner. You can't ask me. Nothing better than that, man. The two best in the sport is just amazing.
Gail says, get your ass on that plane, let's go.
That's exactly what she said. She was like, listen. because I was going out to LA and I would be out there for a week, 2 weeks, come back home for 2 weeks. But I went back to Florida, that's like flying to Europe. So come all the way back to Florida, take 8 hours to get home. Then go back out to LA in 2 weeks, stay out there for 2 weeks. So I was going back and forth at first, spending all this money, rental cars and all that stuff. She was like, babe, you might as well just go out there, get a little apartment, that way you got to let all your luggage back and all that stuff, and they start using some other. Now I got something to do out there. I'm like, one in Florida. I'm like, damn, I should be back in LA. So I got so many shoes out there. Now, you know, I'm doing love everybody if you don't know me by now.
Well, you got two options. One, you can borrow some shoes from Phil. He's got 5,000 pair.
Look at all those shoes too. Yeah.
B, you can actually buy some new ones with that nice $150,000 check you got last night.
I think that's all money, man.